Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved official exam question, we are going to determine the differential equation that governs the variation of the voltage across a capacitor fed by a constant voltage. Determine the constants A, B, and tau in the solution of the differential equation. Calculate the values of tau, E, and R. Determine the differential equation governing the variation of the discharge current. Verify the solution of the differential equation of the current. Calculate the electric energy lost by the capacitor during the time interval 0 to 2.5 tau. Calculate the thermal energy dissipated by the resistor during the same time interval.
The aim of this exercise is to study the charging and the discharging of a capacitor of capacitance 1 microfarads. For this aim, we connect the shown circuit. This circuit is formed of the capacitor, an ideal battery of electromotive force E, a resistor of resistance R, and an SBDT switch K. Take the direction of the charge current as a positive direction. Charging the capacitor. The capacitor is initially uncharged, and the switch is turned to position 1 at time 0. Part 1. Derive the differential equation that describes the variation of the voltage UC equal UBM as a function of time. Applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, UAM is equal to UAB plus UBM. UAM is equal to E, and the positive sense is oriented from A to B, then UAB through the resistor is equal to R times I, and UBM is taken as UC. Look at the figure. The positive sense enters the capacitor through the plate of charge Q, then I is equal to plus dQ by dt. But Q is equal to C times UBM, or equal to C times UC. Then dQ by dt is equal to C times dUC by dt. Now replace I in this equation by C dUC by dt, so E becomes RC dUC by dt plus UC. Now divide by RC both sides, so E over RC equal dUC by dt plus UC over RC.
Let's move to part 3. The solution of this equation is of the form UC is equal to A+Be to the power minus t over tau. Determine the expressions of the constants A, B, and tau in terms of E, R, and C. To determine the expressions of the constants, first we must differentiate UC with respect to time, and then we will substitute its derivative into the differential equation. So this is UC, and we need to differentiate it with respect to time. The derivative of A is equal to zero because A is constant. To differentiate this expression with respect to time, let me remind you with this remark. If you have a function A times e to the power bt, where A and B are constants, then its derivative with respect to time is AB times e to the power bt. So this is going to be dUC by dt is equal to 0, which is the derivative of A, plus B into minus 1 over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. This is going to be minus B over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Now this is our differential equation. We will replace dUC by dt and UC by their expressions. So we will get this equation. This term is dUC by dt, and this term is UC. Rearrange. This is going to be minus B over tau, e to the power minus t over tau, plus A over RC, plus B over RC, e to the power minus t over tau, is equal to E over RC. Let's take B, e to the power minus t over tau as a common factor. We will get this equation. Now, the right side of this equation is constant. Then the left side must be constant. This term is constant. Now, this term must be constant, but the exponential function is a variable. So this term is constant only if minus b over tau plus b over rc is 0. then this is going to be A over RC is equal to E over RC, which means that small a is equal to E, and minus B over tau plus B over RC is equal to 0, which means that tau is equal to RC. Now we determined the expressions of A and tau. We still have B. How can we determine the expression of B? At time 0, UC is equal to 0. So let's replace UC by 0 and T by 0 in the expression of UC. This is going to be 0 is equal to A plus B times e to the power 0, which means that B is equal to minus A, but A is equal to capital E, then B is equal to minus capital E. Let's move to part 3. In this graph, we have the voltage across the capacitor as a function of time. The straight line, OT, represents the tangent to the curve you see at time 0. Question 3a, determine the value of tau. Look at the graph. Here we have the asymptote whose equation is UC is equal to UC max. We know that the tangent to the curve UC at time 0 cuts this asymptote at a point whose abscissa is tau. Therefore, tau is equal to 1 millisecond. Part 3b, determine the values of E and R. Let's start with the value of E. We know that at time tau, UC is equal to 0.63 E. So this is tau on the graph, it is 1 millisecond. Now, when the abscessa is equal to 1 millisecond, UC is equal to 7.56 volts. Then, 0.63E is equal to 7.56 volts, which means that E is equal to 12 volts. Finally, let's calculate the resistance R. You know that tau is equal to R times C, then R is equal to tau over C. Tau is equal to 1 millisecond, which becomes 1 times 10 to the power minus 3 seconds, and C, it is given in the beginning of the question, it is equal to 1 microfarads, which is equal to 1 times 10 to the power minus 6 farads, and the answer is 1,000 ohms.
Discharging the capacitor. The capacitor is fully charged. The switch is turned to position 2 at time 0. Part 1. Indicate the direction of the discharge current. We know that during discharging, the current leaves the positive plate of the capacitor. So, the discharge current flows in the discharge circuit in the clockwise sense. Number 2. Show that the differential equation in the current is of the form of I plus RC dI by dt is equal to 0. Applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, UAM is equal to UAB plus UBM, but Q is equal to C times UBM, so UBM is equal to Q over C, and UAM is the voltage across a connecting wire, so UAM is equal to 0. Look at the figure. The positive sense is oriented from B to A through the resistor, so UAB is equal to minus R times I. In this equation, we have two variables, I and Q, and we have to determine the differential equation in the current I. So we must replace Q by an expression containing I. So we have to differentiate both sides with respect to time. So the derivative of 0 remains 0. The derivative of minus RI becomes minus R dI by dt, and the derivative of Q over C is equal to 1 over C times dQ by dt. Since the positive sense leaves the capacitor through the charge of plate Q, now I is equal to minus dQ by dt. So replace dQ by dt in this equation by minus I. So 0 is equal to minus R dI by dt plus 1 over C times minus I. Now, multiply by minus C both sides So RC dI over T plus I is equal to 0, which is the differential equation in the current during the discharging.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 3. Verify that I, which is equal to I0 times e to the power minus t over tau, is a solution of this differential equation, where I0 is equal to capital E over R. Now, to verify that this expression is a solution of the obtained differential equation, we must differentiate it with respect to time, and then we substitute the derivative into the differential equation. But how can we differentiate the exponential function? Let me remind you with this formula. If you have a function a times e to the power bt, where a and b are constants, then its derivative with respect to time is ab times e to the power bt. Therefore, di by dt is equal to I0 into minus 1 over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Now, this is our differential equation. So, we will replace di by dt by this expression and I by this expression. This is going to be RC into minus I0 over tau e to the power minus t over tau plus I0 times e to the power minus t over tau is equal to 0. Now, you know that tau is equal to R times C. Replace RC in this equation by tau. We will get this equation, and this is going to be minus I0 times e to the power minus t over tau plus I0 times e to the power minus t over tau is equal to 0. Therefore, this expression is a solution of our differential equation.
Part 4. In 4a, calculate the value of the current at time 0 and at time 2.5 tau. Using the expression of the current, at time 0, replace each physical quantity by its value. E is equal to 12 volts, R is equal to 1,000 ohms, and T is equal to 0. So at time 0, the current is equal to 12 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. At time 2.5 tau, similarly, replace each physical quantity by its value. E 12, R equal 1,000, and T equal 2.5 tau. So I is equal to 0.012 e to the power minus 25, which is equal to 9.85 times 10 to the power minus 4 amperes. 4b, deduce the value of UC at time 2.5 tau. We proved that 0 equal minus RI plus UC. So UC equal RI. Now substitute R equal 1,000 and I equal 9.85 times 10 to the power minus 4, so at time 2.5 tau, UC is equal to 0.985 volts.
Let's move to part 5. Deduce the electric energy lost by the capacitor between time 0 and time 2.5 tau. To calculate the electric energy lost by the capacitor, we need first to know the energy stored in the capacitor at time 0 and at time 2.5 tau. So first, the electric energy stored in the capacitor at time 0 is given by 1 half C E squared. C is equal to 1 microfarads and E is equal to 12 volts. And the answer is 7.2 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules. Now, what is the electric energy stored in the capacitor at time 2.5 tau? The remaining electric energy stored in the capacitor at this time is equal to 1 half C U C squared. At time 2.5 tau, we found in the previous slide that the voltage is 0.985 volts across the capacitor. So the remaining electric energy is 4.85 times 10 to the power minus 7 joules. Now, look. At time 0, the electric energy stored in the capacitor is greater than that at time 2.5 tau because the capacitor loses electric energy during the discharging process. Now, the energy lost by the capacitor is equal to the initial electric energy minus the remaining electric energy. So we have 7.2 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules minus 4.85 times 10 to the power minus 7 joules. And the answer is 7.15 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules.
Part 6. The energy dissipated due to Joule's effect in the resistor between time 0 and time 2.5 tau is given by Wh equal the integral of Ri squared dt between t0 and t1. 6a. Determine the value of Wh. Using the expression of the current, I equal E over R exponential minus t over tau. Then I squared can be replaced by E squared over R squared e to the power minus 2t over tau. But R over R squared is equal to 1 over R. And E squared over R is constant. So Wh can be written as E squared over R integral e to the power minus 2t over tau dt between time 0 and time t1. Remark, u is a function of time. Then the integral of eu du between time t0 and t1 is equal to e to the power u over u prime between t0 and t1. But e to the power u is similar to e to the power minus 2t over tau, where u is equal to minus 2t over tau. Then the integral of this exponential function can be written as e to the power minus 2t over tau over minus 2 over tau. So Wh can be written as minus tau e squared over 2r exponential minus 2t over tau. But tau can be replaced by r times c. And e to the power minus 2t over tau between 0 and 2.5 tau is equal to e to the power minus 2 over tau into 2.5 tau minus e to the power 0. R cancels R. Then Wh becomes minus c e squared over 2 into e to the power minus 5 minus 1. Replace c by its value and e by its value. C is equal to 1 times 10 to the power minus 6 farads. E is equal to 12 volts. So Wh is equal to 7.15 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules. 6b. Compare Wh and We and then make a conclusion. In the previous slide, we proved that We is equal to 7.15 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules. So Wh is equal to We. What do we conclude? During the discharging, the energy lost by the capacitor is equal to the energy dissipated in the resistor of the circuit.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.